We are very fortunate to be able to work with a lot of very gifted people in studying these families with kidney cancer. So we've studied, we follow more than 1,000 families who have cancer of the kidney. The first one was von Hippel-Lindau. It took us 10 years to find that gene. And we found that in the early 90s, in 1993, and we and others have been studying that gene pathway, the VHL gene pathway, since. And up to now, the FDA has approved 7 drugs that target that cancer gene pathway for patients with advanced kidney cancer. So we're thrilled about that.
The gene alteration, the mutation that you have in the VHL gene is actually a deletion of the gene. In other words, it's loss of the complete gene. We find that it's much harder when people have that mutation of the VHL gene, it's much harder for them to get kidney tumors. So we think that's why you, at the age of 43, have only one tumor in your kidney, whereas many patients have multiple tumors.
Okay.
The second hereditary cancer syndrome that we study is called Burt-Hogg-Dubé, BHD. That's another hereditary cancer syndrome in which patients develop cutaneous fibril folliculomas, skin bumps, and pulmonary cyst and kidney cancer. So we described the kidney cancer going with Burt-Hogg-Dubé in the 90s, and it took us a number of years to find that gene, which we called FLCN. Now that gene, it turns out, changed everything we know, changed our entire direction in our study of kidney cancer, because that gene is obviously very metabolic. That protein, folliculin, and its partners bind another protein called AMPK, which is critical to cellular energetics. It's the energy sensing superhighway of the cell. And it turns out that this cancer gene and its binding partners bind AMPK, and they have a big role in affecting how the cell senses nutrients. The third gene that we study is the most incredible in many ways. This causes a hereditary cancer syndrome called HLRCC, hereditary leiomyomatosis and renal cell cancer. So we saw our first patient with this in 1989. It hadn't been described then, and it's an 18-year-old young woman who came up here from Charlottesville. I took out her kidney. She went on to die 9 months later of metastatic kidney cancer, and her mom died 14 months after that. Well, we never forget a patient, we never forget a family. It took us 18 years to figure out what that young woman and her mom had. And we know now that that's hereditary leiomyomatosis, renal cell cancer, HLRCC, where they get what are called leiomyomas, which are little muscle tumors in the skin and in the uterus, and they get a very aggressive type of kidney cancer. So the gene for this was found in 2001, and shockingly, the gene for this is the gene for the Krebs cycle enzyme fumarate hydratase, or FH. So how on earth, we thought to ourselves, does mutation of a Krebs cycle enzyme cause cancer? So what we and others have shown is that when FH is deficient, it's mutated in these cancers undergo a metabolic shift. They shift to aerobic glycolysis and decreased mitochondrial function, decreased oxidative phosphorylation. This, unfortunately, this is called the Warburg effect in cancer, and this gives these cancer cells an incredible advantage. The other thing we have found over the years is that even though these are an incredibly aggressive type of cancer, they also this cancer also has a big Achilles heel. They're very, very dependent on glucose, on sugar, for metabolism and for energy and for making energy. So we have studied this pathway, have developed a number of therapeutic approaches for patients with HLRCC kidney cancer, and we're very, very encouraged about the progress of those clinical trials. Now, we also study another type of inherited kidney cancer, which is also caused by a Krebs cycle enzyme. This one is succinate dehydrogenase. And we have a number of families with succinate dehydrogenase mutations in their germline, and they get SDH-deficient kidney cancer, which is also a very aggressive form, very aggressive type of kidney cancer. So we are working on developing, similarly, a therapeutic approach for patients with SDH-deficient kidney cancer.